In this video, we address both voltage and frequency stability in microgrids. The main learning objectives will fall under four main questions. Firstly, what is the definition of stability? Secondly, what is the classification of stability in traditional power systems? Thirdly, what are the main stability issues in microgrids? Fourth, what are the response time of various DG units that determine the level of frequency stability in microgrids? The stability is defined as the ability of an electrical network for a given initial operating point to regain a state of operating mode after being subjected to a physical disturbance. For an input disturbance shown in purple color, the closed loop response of the whole system can be either stable, marginally stable, or unstable. If the system remains stable after the disturbance, then the response could be either oscillatory or non-oscillatory. If the system is marginally stable, then it will never reach a stable point and remains oscillatory. And finally, if the system has an unstable response, it could be either with or without oscillations. Before we start to describe the classification of stability in microgrids, we first have to learn and introduce the stability classification in traditional power systems. In general, the stability of traditional systems can be divided into three general groups, namely rotor angle stability, frequency stability, and voltage stability. In this slide, we show the first group, which is rotor angle stability. Rotor angle stability is defined as the ability of interconnected electrical grids to remain in synchronism when they are subject to disturbances or faults. For instance, single phase or three phase to ground faults. Rotor angle stability is the shortest stability phenomena for about few hundreds of milliseconds, which in general is divided into either a small signal stability or transient stability. Frequency stability can be considered for both short time scale within several seconds or long time scale within several minutes up to hours. In electric power systems, ideally speaking, active power balance between the power produced by generating units and the electrical demand must be instantaneously maintained and satisfied for both short and long-term scales. To operate the electrical grids in a stable manner, not only the frequency shall remain within allowable limits, but also voltage shall be stable and controlled within maximum and minimum allowable limits. Voltage stability can be grouped into large and a small disturbance stability. It is worth emphasizing that the classification of stability in microgrid is different than the one of traditional power systems due to several reasons. If the microgrid is connected to the external grid, then obviously the size of microgrid is relatively small compared to the whole system. Therefore, the frequency of microgrid is dominantly set by the grid. However, the voltage, which is a local signal, can be affected by the operation of microgrid. In other words, only the voltage stability can be classified and addressed when a microgrid is connected to the external grid. If I landed, both voltage and frequency stability can be classified and studied for both short-term and long-term time periods. If the microgrid is connected to the grid, then transient voltage stability is a relevant problem, particularly during upstream network faults. We remind that transient voltage stability refers to the capability of a system to maintain synchronous operation when they are subject to the faults. As it is shown in the figure, there are grid codes with which microgrids shall comply during faults to reach a stable point after the fault. During the islanded mode, maintaining the stability of frequency in microgrid is a very challenging task. In the first place, we describe primary frequency control, which is responsible for continuously adjusting the frequency variations, which occur due to disturbances like power outages. Note that this control is automatically and locally activated by the so-called droop control of DG units in microgrids to arrest the initial frequency drop right after a contingency event. If the frequency does not reach a stable point after the disturbance, then the islanded microgrid is shut down. Though the droop control is simple to implement, it has many disadvantages for droop-based microgrids, such as poor transient performance or possible frequency instabilities. As it is shown, significant variations in both real and imaginary components will occur according to the changes in the operating conditions of DG units, like DG power increase. So, for instance, when the penetration rate of DGs increases, then it may enter the unstable region. As shown in the figure on the left, we show the overall stability margin of the system versus the power increase of the DG. It can be seen on the figure on the right that the increase in the penetration rate of DG first helps improve the stability as the phase margin increases. But further increase in DG power will lead to low values of phase margin and eventually unstable operating modes. After primary frequency control, the secondary frequency control will be activated, which is also known as the load frequency control. The secondary control is the main responsible to recover the frequency to the nominal value. In islanded microgrids, various components could support secondary frequency control, such as batteries. However, as secondary control is a long-term service, we shall ensure that enough energy storage is available and is stored in the batteries. Otherwise, the microgrid will shut down. In the previous slides, we discussed the frequency stability. However, it is important to emphasize that frequency stability in microgrids also highly depends on the behavior and response time of the components which are connected. In general, variable speed wind turbines are able to vary their active power very quickly following the frequency disturbance thanks to their power converters. However, as the rotor speed dramatically drops, they have to reduce their power support after a certain period of time, typically after tens of seconds, depending on the inertia of rotor mass. Therefore, wind turbines can support the frequency only for a short period of time. On the other side, fuel cells are typically represented by a large time constant, due to which their response is very slow. Therefore, they are not suitable for primary frequency control and are mainly used for secondary control. Then, what about PV solar units? In fact, they are typically operated at their maximum power point, at which obviously they are not able to increase their active power. Therefore, photovoltaic solar units cannot be used to fully support the frequency, particularly during the moments where an increase in power generation by PV solar units is needed for frequency control. Well, what about other components like gas units and batteries? Well, gas units typically provide a very fast response with a small time constant. However, their response might be associated with some oscillations. Therefore, they are very good candidates to support the frequency for both short and long-term periods. Similarly, the battery is able to instantly respond to power changes thanks to its fast power electronic interfaces. Therefore, they can be also widely used for frequency control. In this video, we addressed first the stability classification of traditional power systems. And then we detailed the stability of microgrids. We mentioned that while the voltage stability is the main issue for microgrids during grid-connected mode, both frequency and voltage stability are to be addressed in microgrids during islanded operation. As the frequency stability of microgrids largely depends on the response time of available components, we also studied the response time of various components in a microgrid.